Hello and welcome to Designer How, back with another great tutorial for you today. Let's get right into it. We've got the footage we want to treat on the timeline. Let's duplicate it by holding Alt or Option, then dragging and releasing it above the original. First, we want to go into Effect Controls of the copied clip. Under Opacity, set the Blend Mode to Screen. Then we'll head to Effects and begin throwing the following effects onto our copied layer. Extract, Find Edges, Tint, Turbulent Displace, and VR Glow. Select the copied clip and press Enter to render, because all these heavy effects are murder on poor little old Premiere's knees. Now we'll go into Effect Controls, and under Extract, we'll bring all the parameters down to zero. Create a keyframe for white input level where you want the effect to start. Drag the timeline to where you want it to finish and drive it up to about 200, creating a second keyframe. Scroll down to Find Edges and check the box for Invert. Under Tint, select your desired color for the effect. It might be wise to save the color hex code as we'll be using it again in a second. Now, under Turbulent Displace, set amount to 90, size to 20, and change anti-aliasing to high. Under VR Glow, set Luma Threshold to 0.5, Glow Radius to 25, Brightness to 3, and Saturation to 10. Then for Tint Color, use the hex code you copied or set a color that's similar. Already starting to look like something. I think the effect could do with a subtle fade out, so we'll head back up to Opacity, create a keyframe just before the end, which we'll set at 100, and one at the end, which we'll put at 0. I think the effect might be a little harsh and could do with some subtle meshing. Go to Project, click on New Item and select Adjustment Layer. Drag that from the project panel onto the timeline above your clips where the effect takes place. We'll use the arrow button to skip onto the exact frame on which the effect starts, and cut or move the adjustment layer to match that. Now go to Effects, and type in Fast Blur. Drag the blur onto the adjustment layer, and select Vertical under Blur Dimension in Effect Controls. Create a keyframe for blurriness at the beginning of the adjustment layer, and drag the timeline forward a tiny amount. Set blurriness to 6 on this keyframe. The blur will help in meshing the effect with the footage and making it pop more. Now we'll add two last keyframes to end the blur for the effect. The first one at 100, the final one at 0. Lastly, it is time for some special sauce. It would be cool to shake the camera to add some intensity via transform. This is kind of a hassle though. Luckily, I have a preset already and made that I'll throw on there as well. I will add it for free in the description, so you guys better subscribe. Or else I might cry. Ladies and gentlemen, behold the result. See you all on the next one.